A short history of sunscreens and why they suck. Mud, too dirty. Zinc oxide, too chalky. In the 1920s, we got phenyl salicylate, not protective enough. In the 1930s, we got pyrimethylbenzoic acid, what it stained people's clothes and people were allergic to it. Fast forward to the 1980s, we have avobenzone, oxybenzone, octosalate, octocrylene, and octinoxate. Guess what? They all absorb through skin. It turns out 1970s chemicals weren't that great for you after all. Sunscreens should say on your skin, not your liver and kidneys. Moms are scared. Europe is banning them. Hawaii doesn't want them touching their reefs. That's why Congress has mandated a brand new pathway to approve sunscreens and bring them to market even faster. Soliome is disrupting a $20 billion industry in sunscreens, not with chemicals, not with minerals, but with peptides. Biological compounds that are already found in your body, so you know they're safe for you, your kids, and the whole planet.
Our flagship peptides absorb UVA and UVB radiation 2 trillion times a second and they never get tired. Our testing shows that our sunscreens last 10 times longer than the leading chemical sunscreen, meaning that you're protected all day, not just a couple of hours. And when you're done with our sunscreens, they form vitamins and nutrients that even coral will appreciate.
How does it feel on your skin, I mean?
Insatiable.
Here's how we do it. Isolate, ozonate, dehydrate, formulate, package.
At IndieBio, we've gotten to the gram scale in 2 weeks and get to the kilogram in 6. And nobody can copy us. We've got the IP.
This $20 billion industry is being disrupted on two sides. Governments and consumers are boycotting it. The FDA is approving brand new ingredients faster than any time in history. Unlike zinc oxide, our peptides aren't just reef friendly, they're reef beneficial. And we have collaborations at Stanford that are proving this. Protect you, your kids, the planet, with us.